Hello everyone, and welcome to our Moodle Academy webinar, Introduction to Gamification. I'm Mary Cooch, Education Manager at Moodle HQ, and with me today I have Vasilis Palilis, who is the Director of Wide Training Academy, Wide Services, and Dr. Mark Glynn, who is the Head of the Teaching Enhancement Unit at Dublin City University. And the three of us together are going to be talking to you about various aspects of gamification. So we will each take an aspect of gamification and talk for about 10 minutes. We'll have questions in between our talks and then hopefully plenty of room for discussion afterwards. I'm going to be talking to you about the background, the history of gamification, what exactly it is. I'll pass over to Vasilis, who will talk about the practical aspect, the setup of gamification. And then Mark is going to give us some real life examples of how gamification is used in Moodle courses in an organization. So let's begin. So I am going to talk to you a little bit about what gamification is and the background or the history to it. And in actual fact, if you've joined the course, because attached to this webinar is a course, and please do go through the activities in the course and get your gamification badge, then attached to the webinar in the course is a course pre-check. And the course pre-check asks the question, how long have teachers been gamifying learning? For about 5 years, all the way up to for a very long time? And you're asked to give your answer. It doesn't count towards the final badge, don't worry. It was just a question. And looking at the quiz results so far, I'm pleased to tell you that most people realized that actually teachers have been gamifying learning for a very long time, even though the internet is not that old, and even though the term gamification is not that old, actually teachers have been gamifying their learning for ages. Now, in the 1960s, I was a pupil in an elementary school, primary school, as we call it, because I'm that old. And even then, our teacher, he would gamify our learning by every Friday, we would have a race to see who was the fastest person to fill in their multiple times tables, and we'd be awarded with a chocolate bar. And that was gamification even before the term was invented and before we started using it online. We are going to be talking about gamification online particularly, but it's important to realize that it isn't only about online, and it isn't only actually about learning. So if we take a look then at how could you define gamification? Whenever I define something, I always like to, first of all, say what it is not. And so in my mind, gamification is not video games. You see here, if you can see, there is a screenshot of two people with video controllers playing a game. So it's not online games. Although you can use games in a gamified course, that's not the main purpose. That's not what it's about. Nor is gamification about what we call serious games. So serious games, for instance, this screenshot shows someone in a medical environment, an operation. Again, you may include them, but it's not gamification. Many people think gamification means gaming and games. It's not, nor is it role play, or some people call it cosplay, as this screenshot shows two people, a man and a woman. I think this is it, cosplay in flowery costumes. I would love to know what they're doing, but certainly this is not the main purpose of gamification. So what is gamification then? Gamification is, I'm going to give you what I see as some key words that describe the gamified elements of a course. Gamification is involvement. This is a screenshot of some people in synchronized swimming. So when you're in a gamified course, you feel involved. You feel engaged, participating. Gamification is about choice. So you feel that you have a choice in where you take your learning through the course. This is a screenshot of four paths which are leading to the same house. Similar to that, gamification is about control. This is a screenshot of someone, a woman who is telling us she's doing it her way. She feels she is in control. I smile at the words choice and control because although you feel in a gamified environment you have a choice and you're in control, actually it depends on how the teacher or whoever has set it up, how much choice and control you have. But it's important that you feel you have the power. Gamification is about rewards. This is a screenshot of a dog who is being given a little reward by his owner. And in a gamified environment, you will have rewards, maybe short rewards like badges at each stage as you progress. Maybe you will have a large reward at the end, such as a certificate. Gamification, of course, we want it to be fun. That's the idea. This is a screenshot of a little dog who's having fun with a water hose. And so if it's not fun, I would be slightly worried. You won't enjoy it. Gamification also involves progress. This is a screenshot of many, many steps heading up to your final destination. And much of gamification involves you feeling that you are reaching different levels or experience points or going up a ladder. Similar to that, gamification is accumulation. This is a screenshot of some piles of coins, gold coins. And again, you can, in some gamified courses or other environments that gamify, get treasure, or sometimes we call it stash, or feel that you are building up resources. Personalization can be another aspect. So this is a screenshot of a little girl who has personalized her hands by coloring them in different colors. Often in a gamified environment, you might be able to personalize your avatar, for example, create your own identity. Adaptability. This is a screenshot, I think, of a chameleon who is adapted to his background. And so there is that element that it will adapt to what you want, that there is an element of adaptability. And learning, you might be surprised to see this, because actually here is a screenshot of a little boy with a laptop and his grandma and a cat. And maybe the little boy is teaching his grandma and the cat how to use the internet. And we, of course, are studying gamified courses in Moodle, but gamification doesn't have to only be or doesn't have to only involve learning. There are other aspects in gamification or places where gamification is used that aren't learning at all. For example, in the sphere of marketing or business, this is a screenshot of a neon light outside a restaurant or a bar, or as we say in England, a pub, calling for happy hour. Happy hour being buy two drinks and get one free. And so of course it's going to motivate you to go into that bar or pub and buy more drinks. So gamification is not only learning in courses. So those are some key words or elements that I've given you to explain it. One of the most popular definitions, I think, is the use of game elements and game design techniques in non-game contexts. And this is an old definition, and it's one that many people use. And if you look at it, non-game context, well, what could be more of a non-game context than having to learn, statistics or philosophy or the subjunctive in French? So it's definitely a non-game context. But the idea of gamification is that we can improve motivation by using game elements. And some of the words that I gave you before are elements of online gaming. So yeah, you will have in online games, you will have this idea of progress, going up different levels. You will have accumulation, gathering treasure or stash. You feel you have a choice where you go. please can everyone mute themselves, you feel that you are able to personalize the situation. Now, in Moodle, as Vasilis will explain to you shortly, in Moodle, Moodle has certain features and activities which you can use to be able to add these game elements. Apologies for the many words on this slide. This slideshow will be shared with you at the end of the webinar. And of course, you'll be able to watch the recording afterwards as well. So in brackets, after each of these elements, I've added the names of Moodle activities or features which can help you achieve this. So for example, if you want to give them a choice, you can use the standard choice activity or a contributed plugin group choice. Where I've added a star or an asterisk, that is for contributed plugins. That means it's not a standard Moodle element, but your admin, if you ask them nicely, may be able to add it. If you want to get, well, activity results block is a standard feature already to show to get an element of competition. There are plugins such as contributed plugins, a level up, completion progress, and so on. You can personalize the experience by filter codes. It allows you to people to see their own names as they're working through the course and others. I'm not going to focus on those because that is Vasilis's section, but ideally such elements and such Moodle features would increase motivation in your course. But, and this is a very big but, a caveat, which is one of my favorite words, you have to be very careful about this. You need to know your learners because you cannot just take a course which has not been very well received, gamify it, and then everyone will be very motivated and your grades will improve. Because we need to consider what's behind the motivation. So extrinsic motivation, for example, we have here a footballer or a soccer player. He's playing because he wants to win a cup, a trophy. He's extrinsically motivated. He might not even like the sport, but he has a goal, if you excuse the play on words. You might be coming to this webinar. Maybe you don't really like Moodle or gamification, but your boss says you have to do it for your professional development. Maybe you might get a promotion. That's extrinsic motivation. Whereas the boy on the right is playing because he likes football. He doesn't mind if he doesn't win anything. He's intrinsically motivated. Maybe you are learning something as a hobby simply because you want to, for the joy of learning. That's intrinsic motivation. And you need to be very careful when you gamify a course. You might like to look at some of the links in the course later. And this fancy name, cognitive evaluation theory, it's basically telling us that if your learners are highly intrinsically motivated, if they're going to do all those activities anyway, they won't thank you if you gamify it by giving them badges as soon as they type their name. They might even feel patronized and it might have the opposite effect of what you want. So use your rewards wisely and think very carefully about whether gamification is right for you. And to help you think carefully about that and to help you make the right decisions and, in fact, how to gamify your course, of course, we're going to pursue and we're going to pass on in a moment, not just yet, but pass on to Vasilis. So in a moment, after we've checked out the chat, Vasilis is going to talk to you about setting up a Moodle course, and he's got an example, which is the course that we are in. And then Mark will talk to you about how it's actually been used in the real world. So it's time. I'm just going to check the chat. Feel free, if you want to watch everything and then discuss afterwards, we should have plenty of time in the second half also to answer any questions. So I'm just going to wait briefly to see if there are any questions or queries now. And if not, then I'm going to pass over to Vasilis. Okay. Martin Haas says, is there a good way of telling how much gamification is just right if you don't know your audience yet? That's an excellent question, actually. I've always found, this is perhaps not the answer you want, I've always found that sometimes it's a question of trial and error if you don't know your audience. Personally, if I didn't know my audience at all, I probably wouldn't embed. I probably wouldn't start with a gamified course. But I'm very interested to know perhaps what Mark Glynn or Vasilis, what their thoughts are on that. I'll just quickly mention to Omid, yes, gamification can work for adult learners if it's the right kind of learners. If we have time in the second half of the session, I'll give you an example of how gamification worked for me as a very old adult who doesn't really like gamification or badges or stash or treasure, but it worked very well. So maybe we can come back to that. Is there anything that Mark, you would like to respond?
Thanks, Mary. Just with regards to the gamification of learners that you don't know, in our case, an example I'll be going through later on is gamification for student orientation. And so we knew the typical students that would be dealing with, that would be coming into the university, but we obviously didn't know them all in detail in the entire cohort. And that still worked out well. But I would say start off small would be the advice that I would give. Start off nice and gentle until you get to know your audience.
Akash says, are there any standard models to implement gamification? I'm not sure there are standard models. There might be good practices. Vasilis or Mark, either of you have any thoughts on that?
Not yet. I believe that at the end of our presentations, it would be these questions more helpful. And
okay. I agree with Anna, who's actually said, I think that some elements of gamification are often used even without realizing that they are gamification elements, such as restrictions that can be used for personalization. Yeah, you might be gamifying your course already and not actually knowing it. And just one final one before Vasilis moves on to his session. Katharina says, you adjust how much gamification is right according to the age of the learners. Personally, I wouldn't go necessarily by the age of the learners. I would go by the type of the learners, really, you know, knowing your learners and whether they'd be into that. Of course, we would expect children more into gamification than adults, but it depends on the subject and it depends on the motivation and other aspects too. Mark Glynn has said, there are several examples in the literature of using gamification and suggested principle as opposed to models. There's a long list of suggested literature in Mark's section in the course, which will be opened up at the end of this webinar. So please go on and read those from Mark as well in his session. Okay, I'm going to pass over to Vasilis. If you'd like to share your screen and talk to us a little bit about the practical aspect of it.
Thank you, Mary, for the opportunity to participate in this course. I am Vasilis and I am the director of White Training Academy, which is the training sector of White Services, the only premium Moodle partner in Greece and Cyprus. Together with Yannis Sarapoglou, the company's director, we have designed many training programs for Moodle. Among them is Gamification with Moodle, which is already 5 years old. I believe that in this program, I present a pedagogical way of creating a gamified Moodle course that could work in the context of an asynchronous, blended or flipped classroom. I will show you how I have gamified the gamified topic of this Moodle course, explaining what I expect to gain from this process. Let's start with the forum history of gamification, both for the perspective of pedagogical theories and from the perspective of gamification. The forum is a great tool since it promotes collaboration. Now about the description. I always ask my learners to create a detailed description for each Moodle activity. Guidance is a competence that an instructor must have within MEC, but from a gamification perspective, providing feedback is crucial to move things forward. Information about the condition of completion, the activity, and personalization in the way of participation, text, or video recording can either meet educational requirements or be considered gamification elements. Ratings differentiate things somewhat. In the context of an educational perspective, it is peer assessment process, while in the context of gamification, it is points. Cooperation versus competition, one of the basic structure of gamification. If we want a completely competitive element, we would add within the form activity the results block, functioning as leaderboard. I did not want to show the actual names here, so I have anonymized them and I have just put the block inside the forum to show the functionality. I hope those of you who got involved in the process have had fun, and those of you who were recognized as the most active players by the community enjoy the hidden reward. The glossary on gamification. Glossaries are also great tools since can be used for several reasons. For example, the topic of this glossary could be considered as a problem-solving activity, requires some research and requires a justification. How, for a possible solution, can be transferred to education. Problem-solving is a rich educational process, also accepted in the context of gamification and games, of course. Now, let's focus our attention on the block RSS feed, which is updated every time there is a new entry in the glossary and keeps the last five of them. At a first glance, it looks like an update of the glossary, but in the gamification perspective, it is an achievement. The reward that a learner will get after adding an entry, something like Andy Warhol's 15-minute eternal. The publicity that the entries gain may act as a motivation for some of the learners to add new entries, thus enriching the glossary with benefits, of course, for the whole community. The group choice activity serves all, I think, the gamification elements. As a component, it serves the creation of teams according to the participants' needs and interests. In the aspect of mechanics, serves the cooperation. In the framework of dynamics, serves emotions, could be important for the narrative, the structure that creates the coherence of the gamified system, and finally improves relationships. After you were informed about John Randolph's model of players, you could participate in this choice activity to select the appropriate group for you. Of course, before starting the group choice, we needed to create the groups that will appear in the activity. Let me tell you that you can always visit it and see the distribution of the participants for each group. Give a moment to reflect on this distribution and think about how you could set up an educational process that covers all groups, the needed differentiation to engage each group, the activities that are suitable as meeting points of all groups, and so on. The last activity in this topic is a feedback activity. In Moodle, teachers are using this activity to collect data for their course from their students. If the analysis page is visible to the students, the activity can be very helpful for them, since they can know at this point how they are doing. This feedback increases their willingness to go further. This particular feedback is under visible groups mode. This means that your choice will be counted in the total sum of choices of the selected group. The analysis page is shown, so you can see what activities are selected for each of the doers group. I suggest you view the result and check if your choices are similar to the choices of the other members of your group, and determine if there are differences between the choices of your group and the other groups. In this feedback activity, there is just one question, and you are asked to select the activities you prefer to find inside a Moodle course. I believe that different kind of doers will select different combination of these activities, but I am not sure if that I have added the appropriate activities or that I have created the appropriate description for this. So you will act as B-testers for this activity. I promise that if stats show some kind of relation between doers groups and activities, I will inform you through this form. Completion progress. I think that the progression bar is the most gamified tool of all we have used until now. It shows us feedback. The progress bar is a real-time feedback about performance. There are also messages explaining what you need to do to fill this bar further. Although this feedback does not force you to do anything, it psychologically creates a dynamic that makes people more likely to progress. Next one, progression. This bar includes a process with various little steps from the beginning to the end, which enables you to move forward to complete this objective. Although there is not a direct message from the system, there is this psychological draw of wanting to progress to the end of the bar. Completion. This is the final point of the bar, the achievement of completion. You look at the bar and you think how close you are to completing this task. You want to achieve 100% completion. I showed you a few things and I tried to integrate them in the educational context and in the context of gamification. Hopefully, I managed to create a topic that attracted you and you got actively involved in it. Generally, there are dozens of activities and blocks in Moodle. I am sure that you can think of ways to use them to serve your educational goals and increase students' engagement. In our white services, white training gamification with Moodle program, a participant has to create his own course in Moodle and combine it with gamification elements. On this slide, you can see some of the gamification elements they used. Level up, group choice, rank, block, game plugin, stats plugin, H5P, and so on. This is the end of this presentation. Thank you for your attention, and I hope that it was useful for you.
Thank you very much, Vasilis. So if you'd like to stop sharing your screen, I'm just going to take a quick look at the chat, and then we're going to move on to Mark Glynn giving us some case studies. So, okay. We've got some great comments about people's favorite plugins, and thanks to Mark for sharing the links there. So Group Choice is very popular, Level Up is very popular, the Completion Progress block, all of which you've mentioned there. And I do very much encourage you, if you haven't already, go into the course where this webinar lives and go through Vasilis's gamified activities so you can see how it works in real life. I'm going to pass over to Mark now, because I do very much want us to have time for a discussion afterwards as well. So if you'd like to tell us about real life use of gamification, Mark.
Thanks, Mary, and thanks, Vasilis. And I can definitely recommend going on a second Mary's recommendation to go on the gamification course done by Vasilis. It's excellent, and it really does do what Mary was saying, show it to you in practice, which is what I want to do here now, is go through a couple of examples where we have used it, and using each of the elements that Mary went through earlier on within Moodle. And there are many, many ways you can do it, but I just want to share with you four or five quick examples. So on the screen here, you'll see how we've used it for signposting students, for telling them where they are, again, with their progress. In this case, what we decided to do was to show, using a label, very, very simply using a label, to see if they'd achieved, completed one, two, three, or four activities. And we changed the label depending on how much of the activities that they had done. We had combined this with the progress bar, but we didn't want the progress bar being so complex that there were so many different squares within it. We wanted to keep it as simple and do it on a step-by-step basis. We also wanted to use graphics that were aligned with the course and the layout and the theme of the course, rather than just the boxes of the progress bar. But we used to two of them together very, very well. The next element that I want to go through is we use one of the features of H5P is interactive video, as you will all well know. And we used a feature within H5P, within the interactive video, and it is called Crossroads. And cutting a long story short, what we had done was gave the students a video, and in this case, it was a nursing video. The nurses, the trainee nurses, are presented with a patient with a particular criteria, and then they're presented with these crossroads. A question which asks them to make a choice as to what their next decision is, what their treatment is, and then the cursor will move to the point in the video that corresponds to the treatment choice that they made. So the video in question was actually about 12 minutes long, but the student's journey throughout the video, depending on the choices, was actually only about 2.5 minutes. So that was quite a useful way to use the gamification, essentially allowing the students to choose their own pathway through it based on their own knowledge. Now, that is a video version of what I've used several times in the past of the lesson tool within Moodle, where you can put in the navigation buttons within the lesson tool to allow them to move to different pages. We just used the H5P in this case because we had it all embedded within the one video, the entire answers within the one video. Excuse me. The next one I want to bring to you is the freedom to fail, that feature of gamification, allowing the students to fail with no consequence. And from a gaming perspective, we've all done it. We've all played Candy Crush, where we've died infinite amount of times, or we played Mario Brothers, where we've died infinite amount of times, but we can just start back again and with little or no consequences. In this case, the education context, we had provided the students with practice quizzes. So the screen is divided in two here. You'll see the practice quizzes were on the left. There was 8 quizzes, one for each of the 8 topics. There was 25 questions for each topic, and they had unlimited attempts to do these questions. And once the topic was open, it was available for the students to do as many times as they like. No consequences, score as high or as low as they like. We just wanted them to learn from the quizzes. And then at the end of the semester, we presented the students with one quiz, and it was made up with four questions from each topic. So remember, there was eight questions. So the final quiz is 32 questions, and they were only allowed one attempt. But each of the questions were pulled from that database of 25 questions across the eight different topics. So they weren't seeing the questions for the first time. Now, again, we used the excellent quiz features functionality within Moodle to control the opening time. And we gave them choice, going back to one of the elements that Mary said, as to when they complete the quiz, anytime between Monday and Friday. But the quiz was locked once they started it. If they started it on Monday morning, they had half an hour to finish it. If they started it on Thursday evening, they had half an hour to finish it. So we gave them choice, but we also had flexibility in there as well. We removed flexibility because they only had a half an hour to do the quiz. So freedom to fail was a feature that went down incredibly well with the students. And the last example, excuse me, but I'm going to split it in two. The last example, and I touched on earlier on, is our student orientation. So we had, we all had online orientations recently because of COVID, but we've even now moved to hybrid versions of online orientation, where we have certain amounts online and certain amounts face-to-face. So using functionality within core Moodle, we had issued badges when they had completed certain stages of orientation. We gave them the orientation before they even registered. So once they accepted their place, we actually were able to share content with them that they engaged with before they even set foot on campus. When they got to key stages, we gave them badges. We asked them to complete quizzes to test their knowledge of the videos. And then we sent them on scavenger hunts, virtual and physical scavenger hunts. And we were giving them rewards. And we also had discussion forums of which they had to participate in them in their communities and in their groups, and then respond to particular tasks, again, through the discussion forums. And through the activity completions, we said they had to complete one post and reply to three posts. Again, all core Moodle functionality. And of course, the last thing then, we were able to give away prizes, whether putting them into raffles when they had completed activities, or whether we just revealed QR codes or discount codes for the university canteen. So all of that was managed through Moodle, and we gamified the entire process. But we took it to another level, and excuse the pun, we used a Level Up Plus plugin integrated into that student orientation process. And for those that are not familiar with the Level Up plugin, it allows us to allocate points to particular activities. And I won't go into each one of the details as to what you can do, but I would highly recommend this, because what it allowed us to do is to quantify the engagement that the students were making within the course. Because we had several different sections within the orientation, and we opened it up where they could engage with any section, we wanted to be able to see how much they engage with it. And we identified key stages within it. And this is what's in the bottom of the screen, where I showed at the very start with no engagement, they're on 0 points, just for logging in and doing some minimal stuff to get to 20 points. A little bit more engagement through getting 10 points here, 5 points there, and so on. They move up to be an explorer at 120 points and so on and so forth until they have the complete course done and fully engaged with their 600 points. So we were able to see how many students engaged, but also at what depth of their engagement, how many points they had got. And we were able to prove to management that we had over 75% engagement with student orientation. And anybody that's involved in orientation in their own institution, getting 75% engagement with anything is an achievement, but particularly something that is potentially as boring as student engagement, where you're listening to somebody at the bottom of a lecture theatre talk about fire exits and how to manage your registration and everything else to go with it. So for me, those particular examples were using, or examples of the elements that Mary touched on, every one of them gives you a huge opportunity to increase student engagement and get them involved. And there's some brilliant stuff in core Moodle, but as we've put in, and I see the chat going like nobody's business here in the corner, you can add to it by adding in some great plugins that have been mentioned already. So that's it, Mary. Thank you.
Great. Thank you very much. Yeah, so we've about 10 minutes to go through some questions. Before we do, though, I would just like to point out that this webinar, as I've said, it lives in a course on Academy. And I know quite a few people have already joined in the discussions in the course. And this gamification course on Moodle Academy is not going to end today. It's going to be there all the time. So please, if we don't get to your question in the chat, or if you're watching the recording, please go and ask your questions in those discussion forums there, because it is an ongoing, continuing course and discussion. And also, I love answering questions, so I will be there for you there. So let's take a look at some questions here. I wanted to point out one of the things you mentioned was the freedom to fail, which I think is really important, you know, absolutely. Although you did then say, Mark, we've all played Candy Crush and Mario. No, Mark, I've never played Candy Crush or Mario Brothers, but maybe the rest of you have. Now then, we've got some questions about Level Up. Thanks, Rob, for putting in the link to Level Up Plus. And talking about, can you use Level Up with the grade book? Thanks also to Rob for answering that. Akash is asking, what are some good practices to gamify a course to be done by a learner individually? That's really interesting because, you know, we often think about a course where you've got lots of people and you can put them into groups and the competition, but what if you're just on your own? You know, and if it's a self-paced course where you're on your own, a bit like this one on Moodle Academy, but either of you have any thoughts on that? I see you've unmuted yourself, Vasilis. Did you want to say something?
Yes. I saw this question and I loved it. Oh. Self-paced courses are most of the common courses. In this case, my opinion is that to follow the three F's of Gabby or the Nicole Lazaro, four elements of fun. One of these is the hard fun, that it's the appropriate for a self-paced course, challenges, overcoming obstacles, problem solving, mastering, completing something. These things are fun because we reach a point where we have accomplished something. We overcome a situation. That is something that a self-learner, individual learner, can self-compete, if I can use this expression.
Thank you. Interestingly, talking about gamification in a course where it's an individual, Martin asked a question earlier, are quizzes fun though, or are they a chore? A pub quiz is fun, but a course quiz isn't, unless it's a Space Invaders game course quiz. There is a plugin called Quiz Venture, which allows you to do that. But I did want to pick up on something I mentioned earlier. In terms of, I'm not a gamification person, but I did join a course. It was a Moodle course. I didn't realize it until I joined, to help me with my Russian studies. And they had literally hundreds of quizzes, grammar quizzes that you had to go through, and you had to get full marks or you had to start all over again. And I thought, I'm not going to do this. This is no fun. But they had the completion progress block. And what it happens is when you pass the quiz, it goes green. And the more quizzes you pass, the greener it goes. And I was really motivated to get the whole block green. So I went through the quizzes again and again. And I think that worked perfectly, even though I wouldn't call myself a fan of gamification or badges. And I was on my own and I was basically competing against myself in that environment. So I'm not saying whether it was fun or not, but it achieved the goal and it motivated me to continue. I think we've got time for maybe just a couple more questions. If you, Mark or Vasilis, can see any in the chat, you're very welcome to answer them. I'm just scrolling through now. Is there anything else?
Yes, I have a question. Who can gain the reward, the famous reward? And so this is, I think, a good question. Why it is a good question? Because this activity is hidden and will be on the course page after gaining an 80% I think of ratings, of grading in the forum. Why this is important? Because I have given the permission to students, to all of the participants, to rate these activities. This was not just a teacher activity, and I think that is something that is, as always says, an educational procedure and a gamification procedure. Peer assessment for the left hand and what is in gamification, the peer assessment is points, and so on. So if someone of us rates with 5 stars the others ports, all of you will gain the famous reward. This is not something that it's a reward for the whole community, a gift for the whole community. Thank you.
And if I may, Mary, you mentioned there escape rooms being an interesting development. We, through a hybrid of Google Slides and also Moodle, we had built our staff development around escape rooms. Our staff development week was based around the escape rooms last year, and it went again down very, very well. So it was good, virtual escape rooms we built.
Yes, thank you. I was actually going to mention exactly the same thing about escape rooms, and about I watched a presentation where you were talking to that too. It's something I personally haven't explored, but I think it's really interesting. And as a languages teacher previously, and still in my heart, that I know in language learning they use escape rooms quite a lot as well. Right. Any others? Sorry, Mark, go on.
I was just going to say we had embedded the new functionality of Moodle, we had embedded in different clues around the room for them to escape. So they had to find out all of the new functionality that was available for the coming academic year. And once they'd watched those videos or answered those questions or read those pages, they got clues to escape from the room. So it worked very well.
That's great. Olga's just asking if she can find some information about escape rooms. So maybe if you'd like to put something in the chat there. As I'm just going to move on to talking as we're coming up to the hour. And as I said, please ask any questions we didn't cover. Go into the forum in this course and ask them, and we can respond there. But we'd love you to get more involved in Moodle Academy. We have a Get Involved course it's linked to from the front page of Academy, where you can suggest topics. The reason we're doing this gamification one is because it was the one that had the most suggestions. Also, if you feel you have some knowledge, why not contact us to contribute? You get a presenter's badge as well, and maybe to contribute to the courses, as Vasilis and Mark have done with this one. So that would be great if you could do that. And please as well, spread the word about Moodle Academy. If you complete the activities in this course, you will get a badge. You can get other badges too. All the webinars are recorded for people who aren't there at the time. Tell others about it. And if you're an educator, in particular at the moment, and you're quite experienced in Moodle, are you ready for the MEC quiz to see if you would be ready to take that? At the moment, we have a program, a certification for educators, but we are working during 2022 on a similar programs for administrators and for developers as well. So are there any final questions? Some great links Thank you. And links to some other webinars, virtual tours. It would be good if we could make a library of various methods used to gamify our courses. Yeah, please go in and make some suggestions in the course there. I'm going to end the webinar now. And thank you everyone for attending. It's been great. And don't go away. Do come back into the course and start discussing in there, which would be really good.